In this tutorial, we will use three different techniques to find the shortest path from the start to end locations. You will see the steps used to calculate routes by length, routes by cost, and routes by length and cost. Shortest route calculations are done in FME using the shortestPathFinder transformer. This transformer calculates the shortest path from the source node to a destination node on a given road network. The output of the shortest route calculation will be a from-to line that defines the start and end of the path. There are a few important things to keep in mind when using the shortest path finder. First, the from-to input port accepts line features, but not point features. And second, the points on a from-to line should match or snap to a coordinate on the road's network. If they don't, then you can use a parameter to manually set a search tolerance to the nearest network. To run the routes by length analysis, open FME Workbench and create a new workspace. Add an Esri shapefile reader for the route dataset of the from-to line. Add a second reader for the AutoCAD DWG dataset containing a road network. In the Add Reader dialog, click the option for Single Merged Feature Type. This will add all the AutoCAD data as a single layer. Add a shortest Pathfinder transformer to the canvas and connect the input ports. Since the from-to points of the line feature do not snap to the road network, we will adjust the snapping tolerance. Open the parameters dialog for the shortest path finder. Change the parameter from to and network snapping to yes. And set a snapping tolerance of 200. Add an inspector transformer to the path output port to see the output. Go ahead and run the workspace. Now let's review the output. You can avoid traveling the wrong way down a one-way street by using costs instead of distances. To apply a cost to a route requires a clean dataset, where one-way streets are tagged with attributes and where streets have been digitized in the right direction of travel. To run the routes by cost analysis, open the Example 2 workspace, or continue along using the previous example. We will filter for roads that have been tagged as one-way streets by adding a tester transformer to the canvas. Open the Tester Parameters dialog. Set up a new test where the attribute for one-way equals Y. Add two Attribute Manager transformers. One connected to each of the tester output ports. These will be used to assign the travel costs to road segments. Open the parameters dialog for the first attribute manager, the one connected to tester past port. Add two new attributes, forward cost and reverse cost. Set forward cost to a value of 1 to represent the correct direction to travel on a one-way street. Set the reverse cost to a value of 9999 to represent the incorrect direction to travel on a one-way street. Next, open the parameters dialog for the second attribute manager, the one connected to the tester failed port. Add two new attributes, forward cost and reverse cost. Set both attributes to a value of 1. Since these are two-way streets where the travel cost is equal in both directions. Finally, we will modify the shortest path finder to use the travel cost weights we just assigned. Open the parameters dialog. Change the cost type parameter from by length to by two attributes. Set forward cost as the forward cost attribute and reverse cost as the reverse cost attribute. Go ahead and run the workspace. Now let's review the output. You will notice a difference between this path and the previous path in example 1. Example 1 was using one-way streets incorrectly, whereas example 2 avoids doing so. Using only cost attributes to determine a route means that distance is no longer considered. For instance, in our second example, there was no difference between a road of 1 meter and 1 kilometer, provided it is not a one-way street. We will fix this using both length and cost as parameters in the transformer. To run the routes by length and cost analysis, open the example 3 workspace, or continue along using the previous example. Open the parameters dialog for the first attribute manager transformer. Next to the value for the forward cost attribute, click the drop-down arrow and select Open Arithmetic Editor. In the arithmetic editor, add a multiplication symbol and double-click on length. This will multiply the forward cost value by the length of the road segment and give us a parameter that takes into account both length and cost. Repeat this step for the reverse cost attribute. Open the second attribute manager and repeat the previous two steps. Go ahead and run the workspace. Now let's review the output. Notice again the difference in results from examples 1 and 2. Some other considerations to keep in mind when using the shortest path finder are that any number of from 2 lines can be passed into the shortest path finder for multiple calculations on the same network. The from 2 lines defines the start and end of the route, but can also contain intermediate points that the route must pass through. A path can also be weighted by an attribute other than length. For example, each segment of the network can be given a cost related to speed limits, vehicle weight limits, or another factor.